Hi, and welcome back to another video. So today, it is my first hair tutorial on this channel, which I'm pretty excited about. You guys had messaged me a lot asking if I could do a hair tutorial on how I do my pin curls or how I do some other vintage inspired hairstyles. And today I'm showing you how I do my bumper bangs. They were most popular in the 1940s to 1950s. In the 1940s they were much more dramatic, and in the 1950s they were a little bit smaller. I thought today I'd show you how I do my more 1940s inspired bumper bangs. And yeah, without further ado, let's get into it. So the first thing that you will need is a hair rat, I think they're called. This one is not perfect at all, as you can see, but it works. I'd recommend you to get one that kind of is similar to your hair color. And you can decide which size you want. This one is probably a bit more larger, and you can get some that are a little bit smaller, if that's what you like. Then, of course, as for probably every vintage inspired hairstyle, we need a lot of bobby pins. I am using these kind of bobby pins for this hair tutorial. And then, of course, you need a brush. And then I'm also using like a little comb that has this thing so that you can part your hair more easily. Focus, yeah. That's how it looks like, but you don't necessarily need this. So let's get into this. First of all, brush out your hair. By the way, this can work for straight hair as well, but of course I have natural hair, which is very curly. So this is especially for naturally hair, I would say, but I think it could still function if you have straight hair. Now I need to part my hair. So what I'm gonna do is get the hair here on the sides, and then in the front. You see, I'm just grabbing the hair. Like so. So now we have this hair section, and then a bigger section in the back. Now I will make a better part here so that it's not as messy. Yeah, you don't need too much hair in the front. Just make sure that it is enough to cover the hair rat. All right, so it doesn't have to be perfect. That's my part. For the rest, I'm just putting it back, and we will need that later on. So now I look like this, and now it is time to take the hair rat. And I'm taking my hair like this. I'm showing you this from the side. So I put the hair rat underneath, and then I am slowly rolling it like so. You see? So you don't put the hair rat over, you put it under your hair, and then it looks like so from the front. And now you take the bobby pins and secure it, and I always start from the side to secure it. All right, then the kind of silhouette I want to achieve is really this arch, you know? I don't want it flat. I mean, you could do that if you want to, but I prefer it this way. And that's what also makes it more dramatic. So then you have to pin it that way. And I am just taking bobby pins, putting it into the hair rat, and pin it upwards on the side like so. And it can actually take a few bobby pins to do that. Now we're getting somewhere slowly. put one in here. So now what I'm going to do, you can also leave it that way, but what I like to do is I'm putting some bobby pins here onto it to make it look more like an arch. You see? Alright, I think I'm going to leave it that way. You can even make it more dramatic and pin more up like so. And what I'm now doing, the only thing, I want to make it look more even and just more flawless. So I'm taking some pins and also pinning some of these frizzy hair things underneath the red. Now we will come to this back section, and I am just brushing through it quickly, and I will show you how I do like a, I think it's called like a Gibson girl tuck or roll or something, I don't know, but that's what I basically almost always do with my hair. If I don't set my hair in pin curls or something, that's what I do on the back of my hair when I do some 1940s or 1950s updos. You could also use a red for this, but with my hair it also works without a red. So I'm showing it to you from the side. You're basically doing the same thing as with the red, but you're not rolling it underneath, you're rolling it upwards. So, like so. See? I rolled it. And then for a more 1940s look, you can pin it much more lower than for a 1950s look. Because in the 1950s, hair was much more up here. And if I put it lower, it looks more 1940s. And now I basically just secure it with some pins. It doesn't need to be perfect, okay? I just somehow pin it and it creates a roll. And then I'm also pinning it in here so that it actually creates a kind of fake page boy, if that makes sense. I don't know how to call this. Maybe it's this Gibson roll thing. But yeah, it's tighter here and then it goes like, whoop, you see? You could use like a little mirror to see what it looks like from the back, so that's what I'm going to do now. Alright, I think I'm done. It is not perfect, but I personally don't always want it to look perfect. I think it looks fine. So now I will show you how it looks like from the back and from the side. Move the tables and roll the rug up. Shut the windows and lock the door. While I try to dig the little brown jug up, bumps me brother with a solid four. And now that it's all done, you can also put in some accessories, like for example, a big flower on the side, or even here. Or you can also put some other flowers on the sides, you know, you can really play with it. Or you just keep it plain and simple. So that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know if you want to see how I set my hair, so how I do pin curls or some other vintage inspired hairstyles. I actually really enjoyed filming this, so I think I'm pretty open for every kind of request. And yeah, thank you for watching. Bye, guys. Go to the bar, we'll flip your lid. Move the tables and roll the rug up. Shut the windows and lock the door. While I try to dig the little brown jug up. Bounce me, brother, with a solid form.